Hi everyone. So there's some interesting stuff going on the PR right now, and I had a lot of people asking me about this today, so I decided to just make my next video about that. So we had the PTR update yesterday, and today there are a lot of really interesting 150 solo clears popping up again, despite the crazy gems being fixed and most of the stuff being tuned down a little bit. But we can see some results like 5-minute solo Gaudy Aegis. We have a 4-man team with 4 demon hunters, and kind of interesting stuff going on here. And there is actually some other bug that popped up from this new reworked Dregs of Lies gem. This one got changed from a support shard to a pet build shard, and it is actually extremely powerful, especially with this mod here, the second to last one, that gives you up to 100% extra damage and also another 50% extra damage all the time. So essentially every single pet build got a quite massive buff from this. But there is also one really interesting proc that this can have, which is here the last one. So when you die, you have like a cheat death ability and you spawn a shadow clone. And this one is quite interesting and actually does massive amounts of damage on some classes, such as the Demon Hunter and also the Witch Doctor. So I tried this out. The reason for that is that it uses Hungering Arrow as its only skill. And similarly on the Witch Doctor, it uses Corpse Spiders. And the best version actually, I think, is on the Necromancer, where you also have some like 5-minute, 4-minute solo times or something like that, 150 of course. And they use Scythe. So Grim Scythe obviously is a pretty good build when you have a clone that just one-shots everything in the entire radius. So does the Hanging Arrow, but Hanging Arrow is not exactly the right build for this. These Shadow Clones are kind of lazy and barely attack, so it's a single target ability that has to proc arrow damage to one-shot everything, but oh boy, it does hit like a truck. Obviously, this is gonna be fixed very quickly, I assume, or at the very least, this is not going live. And this is just not happening. So I can just recommend to not base your expectations on the build's performance on this, of course. This is a gold demon hunter running around with a pet gem that actually reduces your own damage. This is 100% not going to make it alive, but it is quite funny. I think on the wizard it's like magic missile, so not exactly a build. You do need to have some like big multipliers for such a skill to really make them one-shot GR150. So you can experiment with that. Just LOD and Death Diggers and Simplicity Strength is not enough for this. You need some other big stuff, something like the 9th Theory Essential and the Momentum. So all that stuff seems to work for the Shadow Clone. So the strategy basically is you walk in there, you proc immediately from getting one shot. You have to Shadow Clone out for 15 seconds. It blasts everything around you. And then you die, you revive again and repeat. So yeah, very hardcore viable strat. Or you just wait like this 1 minute and wait for the actual timer to come back, and then you can do it again. Funny enough, there's also no UI indicator whatsoever of when the proc is active or on cooldown or anything. So you kind of have to have a stopwatch running next to you. But yeah, I just did one run of this for fun and tested a bit of, you know, how this actually works. So I believe what happened there is that they gave these shadows some kind of like high base value or like a base multiplier. And then it takes all your multipliers and all your damage on top of that, so that it completely scales one-to-one with all your stuff, but it starts out at a much higher value, basically. So that's why the damage is so ridiculous. So there are some very obvious and easy fixes to make here for the devs. Other than that, I have not really discovered too much really crazy stuff. And I think that overall the season theme is definitely in a good shape now. So I believe this patch helped a lot to make them more interesting, more viable. I really like that they reworked the Dregs of Lies. Was definitely a good idea, so making those pet builds more viable. Definitely great, especially with this Arrowkeer rework that we have and with the Marauders rework that we have. So there is definitely some interesting stuff. And I believe especially this Dregs of Lies could also be made into some kind of legendary or even legendary gem effect for the future, because this gives you a bit of like a flow to the build. So you have like your pet damage scaling up and then you have a pet damage scaling down. It's like a cycle a little bit. It can also influence it a little bit. So that's actually kind of fun to play around with in some cases, depending on how exactly your setup works. On the Marauder Demon Hunter, for example, it slowly starts stacking up with every attack, and then once you start shooting manually, you do a lot more hits, and you can immediately scale it to 100, and then you have like a little nuke phase, which then recedes again down to zero stacks, and you start again. So I like that actually a lot, and it's not like a convention where you always have to watch the timer. Sometimes you just don't really play around it, sometimes we just blast anyway. Overall, I really like this shard, and I think especially for pet builds, this was very well designed to just give them a bit more dynamic. So cool stuff overall. This is already it for this update here. I have a lot more stuff to share. I'm in the process of doing a lot of like retesting of stuff I've already done. Also like the new Marauders, for example, God Demon Hunter. So I have some things to share there, and obviously I'll keep you guys posted. So hope you enjoyed this one, and I'll see you guys next time.